Margaret Blomquist, and I work with NCSU Research and Extension, and we are here in Mills River, North Carolina, in some of our Goldenseal plots today. And we are going to be showing you how to harvest and post-harvest handling of Goldenseal, also some sustainable harvesting techniques to make the most out of your forest farming beds. So this is Goldenseal, or Hydrastis canadensis. Here's a picture of the leaf. This plot is about, has plants from 3 years to 8 years old. Majority of those we'll be harvesting are 5 to 6 years. You'll want to rake back the leaf. Dig it out. While Goldenseal has a fairly shallow rhizome and fibrous roots, all those fibrous roots that can come out from the base of the plant up to 8 to 10 inches are useful in the harvest and will be used. Shake out the dirt. And now I'm getting to where I have a number of small plants with a big rhizome and lots of this yellow fibrous roots. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the largest of these and just kind of tease them apart by hand. We'll do more of this when we get to washing later. You can see that nice rhizome with fibrous roots. Some of these other ones are smaller or have multiple buds, and you might choose to put those back in your bed to grow larger for future harvests. Right, so I've dug that big Goldenseal plant out and realized I have many small rhizomes. These are good size, they're about 3 inches long, and of course keep all these fibrous roots intact as well, because they have good potent constituents in them as well. Because I've harvested these, and I want to continue this bed, while it's a forest farming bed that I planted, I'm still concerned about the sustainability. So I'm going to go ahead and replant one of the smaller rhizomes right in that spot. So and I'm taking out maybe about 70% of that plant, but I'm restarting here so I have a good start for future years. So the best time of year to harvest Goldenseal is in the fall, when a lot of the medicinal active ingredients are going back down into the root. That also gives the plants times to set flower and seed, which is very good for your population's health. Sometimes it can get pretty thick in here, and we'll go ahead and go through, and I'm going for some of the largest plants to thin out and let the younger ones grow up for future harvests, as well as leaving a full area behind me aside for seed production, and just to leave that be. This looks like a nice big one. And again, I'm cutting around, and there are some babies down here, probably from last year's seed, so I'm going to be mindful to leave those alone. Those won't bring in very much weight and will get much bigger if left. So I'm going to leave that little baby in there. Again, getting a lot of your dirt off while you're in the field really helps when it comes to washing time. All right, that's a nice big root. So the market for this Goldenseal really includes the rhizome and as much weight as you by weight there, but also the fibrous roots. And it will be an intact washing and drying process that we will do with these plants. So I want to be careful to include as much as I can. Again, these small ones aren't going to give me very much weight, so I'm going to go ahead and put those right back in. Wow, you can see that yellow color all the way from the base of the stem down through the rhizome and roots. Another reason I like to shake these off in the woods is to keep all this forest soil intact for the health of the bed. Yeah, some nice rhizomes on those.